Hello students, here we are going to continue with the chapter constitutional design, and in this video only two things are there that were left, that is philosophy of the constitution and the constitutional in the institutional design and the institutional design. Philosophy of the constitution. The constitution begins with a short statement of its basic values. It starts with the short statement with its basic values. This is called the preamble of the constitution. The introductory page, of the constitution, in which the basic values are written, that is known as the preamble. Preamble contains the philosophy on which entire constitution has been built. Indian constitution, in this, that is fraternity, equality, freedom, these things are written in the preamble. It provides a standard to examine and evaluate any law and action of the government to find out whether it is good or bad. What is there that we can see, we can evaluate or examine that whatever action has been taken by the government, it is good or bad for the people. This is the soul of the Indian constitution. What is the soul of the Indian constitution? Preamble. Because it lie in it, this lies the basic values of the constitution. In this, what is lying? The basic values of the constitution, right? So next thing is there, institutional design. Constitution of India is very long and detailed document. Those who crafted the Indian constitution felt that it has to be in accordance with the people's aspiration and changes in the society. It means Indian constitution is flexible as well as rigid. It means we can make the change in the constitution, but no single party or no single person can make the change in the constitution. There is need of a majority of the house. Then only there can be changes in the constitution. So they made provisions to incorporate changes from time to time. These changes are called constitutional amendment. Means changes in the constitution is known as the amendment. Constitutional lays down procedure for choosing person to govern the country. It defines who will have how much power to take which decision, and it put limits to what the government can do by providing some rights to the citizen that cannot be violated. That constitution lays down a procedure of choosing or for choosing the person of the country that they who will govern that country. It means elections are there, and that elections has to be done in the constitutional way. It defines who will have how much power. Everything is written in the constitution, that what powers are there with the legislative, executive and judiciary, what powers are there with the other persons, what are the rights with the normal people or the common people, and it put limits to what the government can do by providing some rights to the citizen that cannot be violated. Some fundamental rights are there with the people, and people are having the right to elect their representative, right? So what is there, the government can do, government has to do the work according to the wishes of the people. They cannot do the work whatever they want to do. They can't be violate the rights of the common people. So this was there, and here our chapter is over. I hope you all have got this chapter. If any problem is there, then please contact or message me. Thank you.
स्टे होम, बी सेफ।